Warning. Sodium is a dangerous reactive metal. Wear gloves when handling it and take necessary precautions against reactive and flammable hazards. Greetings, fellow nerds. In a previous video, I showed how bad storage destroyed a number of chemicals like oxal chloride. Now, in that storage unit, I also had some triethylamine. Being several years old, this is certainly contaminated and should probably be discarded. Triethylamine is cheap enough that there is really no point to repurifying it. Nonetheless, I think it's a good demonstration of some of the techniques and theory in case you have similar chemicals you might want to purify. At first glance, the obvious method to purify a liquid like triethylamine is to distill it. This is indeed a good idea, but impurities like water or alcohol would also carry over. So we'll need to destroy them first or render them non-volatile so they don't distill. Now, triethylamine is inert to sodium metal. So we're going to use sodium to destroy most of the reactive impurities. Here I am cutting a piece of sodium. For the amount of triethylamine I have, I do not need a piece this big. So I'm cutting a smaller piece to save the rest. It's coated in mineral oil because that's how it was stored. The oil will contaminate our triethylamine at first, but we'll be removing it anyway by distillation. Okay, there we go. Now let me drop it into the triethylamine. It's better to use multiple smaller pieces rather than one large piece, so cut down further if you can. Anyway, you can see lots of bubbles of a hydrogen gas rising off the surface. This shows our triethylamine has a significant amount of impurities. Most of this is from water that diffused in from the air over the past several years this was stored. A small amount is from ethanol and other decomposition products. The sodium is also reacting with any amine oxides that formed from reaction with oxygen. You can see a sludge forming consisting of various sodium waste products like some hydroxides, alkoxides, and amides. This technique of reacting with sodium to destroy reactive impurities is actually a pretty common technique in the lab and is one of the primary laboratory uses of sodium metal. Using it as a chemical reagent is actually not very popular, precisely because of its indiscriminate ability to react with many things. Sodium is used mostly for purifying chemicals like alkanes, aromatic solvents, tertiary amines, and ethers. But for more reactive chemicals like acids, alcohols, esters, ketones, and so on, it cannot be used as it would react with them. Nonetheless, when you can use sodium, it works very well. It's better than molecular sieves since it also destroys things other than water. Molecular sieves are specific to water and does very badly against other impurities. Sodium can even be used to destroy dissolved oxygen and make high-quality air-free solvents for highly sensitive organometallic chemistry. But I'll leave that for a future video. Now this crust of sludge is going to stop further reaction of the sodium, so I'm going to break it up by putting it on stirring. I'm going to leave it here for a few days to ensure a complete reaction. I recommend periodically opening the cap and relieving the pressure so the hydrogen buildup doesn't cause the bottle to explode. So here we are about 4 days later. You can see there is no more bubbling and the continual hammering by the stir bar has knocked off the crust and made our sodium shiny. The fact that it remains shiny is a good sign that it stopped reacting to make a new crust. So let's distill it. Transfer the triethylamine to a flask and set up a distillation apparatus around it. Now turn on the cooling water and the heating and gently distill it over. By converting all those impurities into non-volatile sludge, we can leave them behind. I didn't put the sodium piece in the boiling flask since the reaction was already done. But if you're pressed for time and don't want to wait the few days for the sodium to destroy all it can, then a fast method is to simply reflux everything with the sodium for a few hours, then distill over. You can be done in one afternoon. If you are going to go that route, then don't use a Teflon stir bar. Molten sodium is one of the few things that destroys Teflon. You'll need a glass-coated stir bar in that case. Alternatively, run without a stir bar and just use boiling chips. Anyway, distillation is done. And there we have it, old triethylamine that has been repurified and ready to be used. I hope this lab technique was useful for you. Thanks for watching. Special thank you to all of my supporters on Patreon for making these science videos possible with their donations and their direction. If you're not currently a patron but would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, then check out my Patreon page here or in the video description. I really appreciate any and all support.